Now, let's take up questions from this exercise MT26. Let's start with the first question. This still has a questions on ratios and all. Okay, the first question. It says A is to B is 2 is to 3. B is to C is 4 is to 5. C is to D is 3 is to 7. Find the combined ratio of A, B, C, D. Let's take two ratios together. So, A is to B is equal to 2 is to 3. Alright. B is to C is equal to 4 is to 5. The values, the common item is B. The values for B are 3 and 4. Let's take LCM of 3 and 4. It is 12. So make it 12. Now to make it 12, multiply the first ratio by 4. So 2 into 4 is 8. 3 into 4 is 12. Similarly, the second ratio is 4 is to 5. So multiplied by 3. So it becomes 4 threes are 12 and 5 threes are 15. Right. So from here we get A is to B is to C equal to 12 is the common number, so 8 is to 12 is to 15, right? So A is to B, 8 is to 12, B is to C, 12 is to 15. So we can combine 8 is to 12 is to 15. Now, so we have A is to B is to C equal to 8 is to 12 is to 15. And the next ratio is C is to D, which is equal to 3 is to 7, right? So common item is C. And the values for C are 15 and 3. So let's do one thing. Multiply the second ratio by 5. So 3 5s are 15 and 7 5s are 35. So now we can combine these two ratios. A is to B is to C is to D. Right? How? C is 15. It is same. So A is 8, B is 12, C is 15 and D is 35. So the final answer of this question is 8 is to 12 is to 15 is to 35, which is second option. Okay. Now the second question, it says rupees 336 divided between A and B so that A gets 5 by 16 of what B gets. What amount does B get? So A gets 5 by 16, so 5 by 16 into B. So basically what we have here is A by B equal to 5 by 16, right? So the ratio of A and B is 5 is to 16 and the total amount to be divided is 336. Question is, what is the share of B? So B share will be simple division 16 divided by 16 plus 5 is 21 into 336. I think it is normally divisible, okay, 16 times. So 21 16 times 336, 16 to 16 is 256, right? So the required value for B here is 256 rupees. Okay, good question, a simple question. Now the next one, the mean proportional between 0.4 and 10. If you remember, how do we define the mean proportion? We say, let's say the mean proportion is X. So it has to be between 0.4 and 10 in such a manner that ratio of 0.4 and x should be equal to the ratio of x and 10, the continued proportion. Okay, that is the meaning of mean proportion. All right, so we have x square is equal to 0.4 into 10. Now 0.4 into 10 is 4, so x is equal to 2. Right, so a simple question again, this is the third option, that is the correct answer. Now let's take up the next question. Now, this question says Sita, Geeta and Rita together earn rupees 1450 and spend 60%, 65% or 70% of their salaries. Now, if somebody, let's say, spends 60 or 70%, how much will save? Right? So, saving will be, for the first person, 60 is spent, so 40% saving. For the second person, 65 is spent, so 35 will be saving. We are simply subtracting from 100. 70% spent, so 30% saving. So if you assume their earning to be X, Y and Z, their savings will be, savings of these three people will be 40% of X for the first one. The second one will be 35% of Y. And the third one would be 30% of Z. X, Y, Z are taken to be their earnings, right? So their savings we have calculated from here. And the ratio of these savings is given as 14 is to 21 is to 15, right? Now the percentage will get cancelled from all of them. Then 5 cancels 40 8 times, 5 cancels 35 7 times and 5 cancels 30 6 times. So we have 8x is to 7y is to 6z equal to 14 is to 21 is to 15, right? Now what happens from here, you can calculate x is to y is to z as x is to y is to z will be equal to x is multiplied by 8. So it is 14 by 8 is to 21 by 7 is to 15 by 6, right? Now 14 by 8 is actually 7 by 4 is to 21 by 7 is 3, 15 by 6 will be 3 5s are, so 5 by 2. So let's multiply the entire thing by 4. If you multiply the entire ratio by 4, you will get 7 is to 12 is to 2 2's are so 10. So the ratio of XYZ, their earnings is 7 is to 12 is to 10. And the total earning is 1450 rupees. Not to forget, the total earning was given. This is X plus Y plus Z. And this is X is to Y is to Z. Now, what is the question asking? The question is asking the salary of Geeta. Geeta means the second person. So the second person means Y. So the value of Y from here, will be equal to, let's say I'll put it here. The number corresponding to Y is 12 divided by 7 plus 12 is 19 plus 10, 29 into 1450. Now 29, 5 times is 145. So it is 50 times. 50 into 12 is 600. So the earning of Geeta has to be 600 rupees, which is fourth option. All right. So easy question, just a slightly tricky one. Now the next question, it says A and B are two alloys of gold and copper prepared by mixing metals in the proportion 7 is to 2 and 7 is to 11 respectively. If equal quantities of alloys are melted to form a third alloy, the proportion of gold and copper in C will be. So A has a ratio of let's say gold is to copper is 7 is to 2. Then B has gold is to copper is 7 is to 11. Now, we have to mix equal quantities from both of them. What we should do is look at this. 7 plus 2 is 9. If you add 7 and 2, you will get 9. If you add 7 and 11, you get 18. And you have to take equal quantity. So take LCM of this 9 and 18. LCM of the sum of ratios. Okay. Now, what is the LCM of 9 and 18? It is 18. So let's assume that we take 18 kg of the first one and 18 kg of the second one. What will happen? Out of this 18 kg, if you divide in the ratio 7 is to 2, you will get gold as 14 kg. We are dividing 18 kg in the ratio 7 is to 2 and copper as 4 kg. See, 9 2's are is 18. So 7 2's are 14, 2 2's are 4. Similarly, the second one, there will be no calculation also because 7 plus 11 is already 18. So gold in the second one will be 7 kg and copper in the second one will be 11 kg directly. So the total gold will be 14 plus 7. Total copper will be 4 plus 11, right? So the question is saying, find the third alloy gold copper in the third alloy, right? So the third alloy C, gold is to copper will be equal to, in the gold will be 14 plus 7, right? And copper will be 4 plus 11. So 14 plus 7 is 21 is to 4 plus 11 is 15. If you divide by 3, it will give us 7 is to 5, right? So the required ratio is 7 is to 5. So this is a very good method. Answer the third option. Whenever you have equal quantity, so what you should do is take LCM of the sum of all the ratios and take that much quantity from each one of them. So here LCM of 9 and 18, 7 plus 2, 9, 7 plus 11, 18. So LCM of 9 and 18, 18. So we assumed 18 kg from both because we have to take equal quantities. Right? Or the other way could have been, instead of 18, we could have taken just 1 kg and solved this. Obviously, the calculation will be a little more in that case. Okay. So answer is 7 is to 5, gold is to copper. Alright. Now let's go to the next question. Now the next one, it says a container contains 30 liters of pure milk. 3 liters of milk is taken out from this container and replaced with water. This process is repeated for 2 more times. So total 3 times. Right? And this is a question of replacement. If you remember, for replacement, we have created a direct formula. If you go back to the theory lectures, you will find it very clearly. For replacement, there is a direct formula which says final quantity is equal to initial quantity into 1 minus R by V whole to the power N, where final quantity is the quantity of milk final, initial quantity is the quantity of milk initial, 1 minus R is the replaced quantity, V is the volume. So in this case, if you see, the volume is 30 liters, right? R is 3 liters, the number of times is total 3, and initial quantity is 30 liters. Now, what there is one important thing that we need to understand, this formula is applicable only for the item not added. Item not added. See, in this case, you are replacing by water. That means you are adding water. Milk is going out. That is fine. Milk should not come back. So for milk, we will apply this formula. So in this question, we will apply this formula for milk. Okay. Now, so final quantity of milk will be equal to initial quantity of milk. That is 30 liter. 1 minus replaced quantity is 3 liter. The volume also is 30 liter. And N is 3. So simplify this. So it is 30 into 1 minus 3 by 10 is 1 by 10. To the power 3, 1 by 10 or 9 by 10. So it is 30 into 9 by 10 whole to the power 3. So it is 30 into 9 cube is 729, 10 cube is 1000. So 0, 729 into 3 is 2187 upon 100. So it is 21.87 liters, right? So this was a direct question based on a replacement based on this formula. Please go back to the theory video and check it whether you remember this formula or not, whether you have learned this or not. So the answer is 21.87 liter, that is third option. It was a very simple direct question. Okay. Now the next one, it says the average of a batsman for 40 innings is 50 runs. His highest score exceeds the lowest score by 172 runs. If these two innings are excluded, his average drops by 2 runs. Okay, so let's say the highest score is H and the lowest score is L. Alright, now what is the average is 50 runs, right? So the total sum for all the innings, total sum for 40 innings is equal to average 50 into number of innings 40. I think we have done the average equal to total sum divided by number. So sum will be equal to average into the number. Here the number is number of innings. A is the average. Alright. So 50 into 40, that is 2000. Okay. Now, if his highest score exceeds his lowest score by 172, that means H minus L is 172. When we say exceed, that means we are talking about difference. So H minus L is 172. This is one equation. If these two innings are excluded, okay, so the total is 2000 minus the highest and the lowest score, then divide by the number of innings will be 38, right? See, out of 40 innings, you are excluding 2 innings, so divide by 38 should be equal to the average drops by 2. So average was 50. If it drops by 2, it will become 48. So from here, we get 2000 minus H plus L equal to 48 into 38. Now, what is 48 into 38? If you multiply carefully, it is 48. 43 squared, that is 1849 minus 25. So it is 1824. All right. So it is 1824. So this gives us H plus L equal to 2000 minus 1824, which is equal to 176. Right. Okay. So H plus L is 176. So we have H minus L 172. H plus L 176. Very nice. Simply, I would say add. So 2H is equal to 348. All right. So H is equal to 174. So the highest score is 174. Okay. And the lowest score is 2. Right. So look at the question. His highest score is 174 runs. So this was a very simple question again based on the very basic concept of averages, right? I have just followed the conventional method. I have not gone into any shortcut method because any shortcut would also, please understand that any shortcut also is going to take the same amount of time that you spend in this process. Always the conventional process, the straightforward process is better. Okay, let's go to the next question now. Next one, the 8th question, he says the ratio of earnings of A and B is 4 is to 5 respectively. The earnings of A increases by 20% and the earnings of B decrease by 20%. The new ratio of their earning becomes 6 is to 5. What are A's earning? Very simple. Let's say the original A and B incomes are, earnings are 4 and 5. Now the new things, what will happen? A's increase by 20%, so plus 20%. Now if something increases by 20%, you multiply by 1.2. Or what you can do is 4 plus 20% of 4, that is equal to 4 plus. Now 20% will be 20 by 180 by 100, so 0.8, which is 4.8. Or what you could have done that is simply 4 into 1.2, that also would have given the same thing, 4.8. Now the second one decreased by 20%, so minus 20%, right? So it is 5 minus 20% of 5. Right. So it is 5 minus 20 into 5 is 100 by 101. So it is 5 minus 1, that is 4. Or what you could have done is that you can simply multiply 5 into 0.8. When something decreases by 20%, you can directly multiply by 0.8. So this gives us this one. So the new ratio is 4.8 is to 4. Right. Now this is 48 by 40, which is 6 by 5. All right. Okay, so this is the new ratio. But if you look at the question, the already new ratio was given. That is 6 to 5, right? And that is correct also. Now the question is, what were A's earnings? Oh, that means in this question, we cannot determine the A's earnings value, right? Only the ratio things are given, right? So the answer will be, cannot be determined. Okay? Cannot be determined in this question. Just be careful. Okay? So answer to this question is cannot be determined. It's actually the fourth option that you can't see, but don't worry. The answer is cannot be determined. Okay. Now let's take up the next question. Now the next one, it says ABC subscribe rupees 50,000 for a business. A subscribes for 4,000 more than B. B subscribes 5,000 more than C. Right. So A is equal to B plus 4,000. B is equal to C plus 5,000. Right. So that means this can be written as in place of B, we can take C plus 5,000 plus 4,000, which is equal to C plus 9,000. So we have converted all of them into in terms of C. Okay. Now we also are given with the information that A plus B plus C is equal to 50,000. Put all the values here in terms of C. So in place of A, we can say C plus 9,000. In place of B, we can say C plus 5,000. And in place of C, C itself, it is equal to 50,000. Okay. So 9,000 plus 5,000 is 14,000. C plus C plus C is 3C. 14,000 goes to the other side and gets subtracted. 50,000 minus 14,000 is 36,000. So from here we get C equal to 12,000, right? So you can calculate whichever you wish to. What is the question asking? A receives out of a total profit of 35,000, A receives. Okay, so C is 12,000. That means this A will be 12 plus 9, 21,000. All right. And B will be 12 plus 5, that is 17,000. Okay. So the ratio of investment will be 21,000 is to 17,000 is to 12,000. So all the zeros will get cancelled and we will have ratio of profit share as A is to B is to C equal to 21 is to 17 is to 12, right? 21 is to 17 is to 12. So it comes out to be 50 only. Oh, fantastic. Now the total profit is 35,000. Question is A's share. So A's share from here will be 21 divided by 21 plus 17 is 38 plus 12, 50 into 35,000. Right? So normal division. So 0, 0 cancel. 5 cancels 3500, 700 times 700 to 21. That will be 7 2s are 14, 14,700 rupees. So the share of A in this question out of a profit of 35,000 is 14,700. All right. Now let's take up the next question. The fourth proportional, how do we write it? We say that it is 5, 8, 15 and the fourth proportion will come at the fourth place as X. The condition is the ratio of first two should be equal to the ratio of second two. The condition of fourth proportional is that the ratio of first two items should be equal to the ratio of next two items. So 5 by 8 equal to 15 by X. Just simplify it. So X is equal to, just see that X is equal to 15 into 8 divided by 5. So 5 cancels 15 3 times, 3 to 8 is 24. So the answer to this question is 24, and that's it. All right. Now the next one, a box contains 320 coins of 1 rupee, 50 paisa and 25 paisa coins in their value worth ratio 2 is to 3 is to 6. Oh, so value worth ratio is 2 is to 3 is to 6. Then find the number of coins of 50 paisa coins. All right. So if I simply say that the numbers are, let's say 1 rupee coin, the number is X. Okay. 50 paisa coin, the number is Y. And 25 paisa coins, the number is Z. All right. So this is the denomination value. This is the number of coins. So net worth, right? The net worth values will be 1 rupee is 100 paisa. 100 paisa into X will be 100X. 50 paisa into Y will be 50Y. And 25% to Z will be 25Z. So what we are doing is we are taking in paisa only, right? So because all of them have to be in the same ratio, same value, same unit. So 100X is to 50Y is to 25Z. This is the ratio of their net worth, right? Now first simplify here, you can divide by 25. This will be 25 4s are. So it is 4X is to 2Y is to Z. Please try and understand that net worth ratio is given as 2 is to 3 is to 6. So this can be taken as 2 is to 3 is to 6. Right. So we have 2 is to 3 is to 6 equal to 4x is to 2y is to z. I'll write it here again. 4x is to 2y is to z equal to 2 is to 3 is to 6. Okay. Now from here, if I want to find x is to y is to z, what do I need to do? Let's see. What we have to do is 4x. If you want to remove 4, then divide by 4 on the other side in the number corresponding to 4x. The number corresponding to 4x is 2. So 2 divided by 4 is 2. Y has 2 here and 3 here. So it will become 3 by 2. And Z has nothing. So it is just 6 by 1. Right? Now 2 by 4 is 1 by 2. So it is 1 by 2 is to 3 by 2 is to 6. So multiply by 2 in the entire ratio, we will get 1 is to 3 is to 12. Right. So the required ratio of the number of coins is 1 is to 3 is to 2. We have found the ratio of number of coins as 1 is to 3 is to 12. Okay, now what is the question asking? The total number of coins is 320. Here the ratio is 1:3:12. What is the question asking? The number of 50 paisa coins. The number of 50 paisa coins means y. So the y value will be 3. This one is y. So 3 divided by 3 plus 1, 4 plus 12, 16 into the total number of coins 320. Now 16 cancels 320, 20 times 20 into 3 is 60. So there are 60 coins of 50 paisa. You can also calculate the number of coins of 1 rupee and 50 paisa as well. Alright, so this was a good tricky question. You know, just remember that from this ratio, we can directly calculate the ratio of XYZ by dividing the corresponding numbers. Whichever is multiplied here, divide by the other side. Divide by that number in the other side also. Okay, now let's take up the next question. Now this 12th question is, the average age of 3 boys is 25 years and their ages are in the proportion 3:5:7, the age of youngest boy is. There are many ways of doing this question. I'll opt for one simple way. If the ratio is 3:5:7, the ages can be taken as 3x, 5x and 7x. So their sum will be 3x plus 5x plus 7x, their average will be divided by 3 and that is equal to 25. This is the simplest way of doing this. Alright. So 3 plus 5, 8 plus 5, 17x by 17x is equal to 3 plus 5 is 8 plus 5, 15. It is 15x divided by 3 equal to 25. Okay. So from here you can see clearly that x is equal to 25 into 3, 75 divided by 15, which is 5. So we've got the value of x. We can calculate the youngest boy is 3x. So 3 into 5, which is 15 years. Right. So the youngest person here is 15 years. There are other ways also, but I think there's nothing great about any other method in this question because the question itself is very easy. Okay. That is 15 years is the youngest boy age. Now the next one, a student was asked to find the arithmetic mean of the numbers 3, 11, 7, 9, 15, 13, 8, 19, 17, 21, 14 and X. He found the mean to be 12. First of all, how many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 numbers are there, right? And what is their sum? Add it here only. 11 plus 3, 14. 14 plus 7, 21. Plus 9, 30, right? Now 15 plus 13, 28 plus 8, 36. Plus 19, 55. I repeat, 15 plus 13, 28. Plus 8, 36. 36 plus 19 is 55. What I'm doing is I'm adding 4 numbers at one place. Now 17 plus 21 is 38 plus 14, 42 plus X. I repeat, 17 plus 21 is 38, right? Plus 14, 38 plus 14 is 52, right? See, there was a mistake earlier. I repeat, 17 plus 21, 38. 38 plus 14 is 52. So it is 52 plus X, right? So, okay. So now the sum of all quantities will be the sum of all these three. So add them. So 30 plus 55 plus 52. So 50 and 50, 100. 130 5 into 7, so 137 plus x. So the total sum is 137 plus x for 12 value. So divide by 12 is equal to, what is the arithmetic mean given? Oh, it is given to be 12, so it is equal to 12. So this is number of items, this is the average value. Okay, so this is number of items and this is the average value and this is the sum. Okay, so I think it's very simple now. 137 plus x is equal to 12 into 12. 12 goes to the other side, gets multiplied. That is 144. So from here, you can see x is equal to 144 minus 137, which is 7. Right? So the answer of this question is just 7. Second option is the correct answer. All right. Okay. Now the next one. 14th question. The average age of husband, wife and their child 3 years ago was 27. So 3 years ago, right, the average age was 27. So there is no confusion. First, we simply say the present average. It does not depend on the number of people, right? So present average age of all those people. How many people? A husband, wife and child. So 3 people. Okay, so 3 people. Here also the same 3 people, but it will be 27 years plus 3 years. So 27 plus 3, that is 30 years. So this is the average of husband, wife and child. So at present, if I say husband plus wife plus child divide by 3, that is equal to 30. So this gives us husband plus wife plus child equal to 30 into 3, that is 90. This is the first condition. Now what is the second condition? And that of wife and the child 5 years ago was 20 years. Okay, so once again, 5 years ago, wife and child, The average was 20. So, first of all, remove this ago situation. So, come to present. What will happen at the present? At present, wife and child average has to be 20 plus 5, that is 25. That means wife plus child by 2 equal to 25. So, this gives us wife plus child equal to 25 into 2, right? That is 50. Okay, so at present, wife plus child is 50. At present, husband plus wife plus child is 90. So, put wife plus child equal to 50, you will get husband equal to 40. All right. What is the question asking? The present age of the husband is 40 years. Second option, that is the correct answer. So, all these are simple questions. The approach does not matter much because these questions are already very easy. Okay. Now, let's take up the next one. Now, this 15th question, it says A's present age to B's present age is to 7. So, 8x and 7x. 27 years ago, the ages were in the ratio 5 to 4. So, 27 years ago, their age would be 8x minus 27 and B age will be 7x minus 27. At that time, the ratio was 5 to 4. Just simplify by cross multiplication. So, 4 into 8 is 32x minus 27 into 4 is 108. 7 into 5 is 35x minus 27 into 5 is 135. That's it. So, bring 135 on this side minus 108 equal to send 32 on the other side. So, 35x minus 32x. So, which gives us 135 minus 108 is 27. That is equal to 3x. So, x is equal to 9. What is the question? Find the present ages. The present ages are 8x and 7x. And x is 9. So, it is 8 into 9. That is 72. And 7 into 9, that is 63. So, the ages are 72 years and 63 years. That is the first option is the correct answer. Alright. Now, the next one, 16th question. Two partners invested rupees 1250, 850 respectively in a business. Both the partners distribute 60% of the profit equally and distribute the rest 40% as the interest on their capitals. If one partner received 30 rupees more than the other, find the total profit. Alright. So, what will happen? Right. So, what is the investment? The investment is 1250 and 850. Let's say for A and B. Okay. Now, if the ratio of investment, if you calculate 0 and 0 cancelled, it is 25 is to 17. What you have to understand is that interest will also be in the same ratio. Because the rate is same, duration is same, amounts are different. So, whatever are the amounts ratio, the interest ratio will also be the same, 25 to 17. Right? Now, why I'm saying this? Because if the, let's say the total, let total profit be 100. Okay? So, out of the total profit, 60 rupees will be distributed equally among these two people. So, it is 30-30. 30 for A and 30 for B. And the remaining 40 will be paid as interest. Right? And the interest ratio is 25 is to 17. That's the important point. Okay? It is 25 is to 17. Alright. So, this 40 will be distributed in the ratio of their interests. That is 25 is to 17. So, if there is any difference in their value received, the difference will be only because of this 25 and 17. Because this 30 and 30 are same. Alright? Now, what is the difference of 25 and 17? The difference of 25 and 17 is 8. Right? And this 8 value corresponding to this 40 will be 8 by 42 into 40. Right? It will be 8 by 42 into 40. Okay? So, this will be, you can simplify a little bit, 2 4s and 2 21s. It is 160 upon 21. So, in this question, this 160 upon 21 is equivalent to 30 rupees. Right? This 160 upon 21, this is equivalent to 30 rupees. Okay. Now, what is the question asking? If that is the situation, find the total profit. Now, total profit is 100. I repeat, out of a total profit of 100 rupees, 60 rupees is to be distributed equally. So, 30-30. Remaining 40 rupees has to be paid as interest. Interest will be directly proportional to the investment. So, investment ratio 25 to 17. So, interest ratio 25 to 17. So, divide 40 in the ratio 25 to 17. Now, the difference of 25 and 17 is 8. So, the value out of 40 corresponding to 8 will be 8 by 42 into 40. Where does this 42 come? 25 plus 17. Right? Basically, we are dividing 40 in the ratio 25 to 17. So, it will be 4 into 40 by 21. That is 160 by 21. This 160 by 21 is the actual difference, which is corresponding to 30. So, how much is 100 equivalent to? So, we can directly apply the unitary method calculation. It is 100 into 30 divided by 160 upon 21. So the 21 goes up, okay, and it becomes, in fact, 10 is also cancelled. So 100 into 3 is 300 into 21 divided by 16. Let me write it here. It is 300 into 21 divided by 16. So I think what we can do is we can divide by 4 times, and 4 75 times. 75 into 2 is 15, 75 divided by 4. So divide normally. If you divide carefully, it will come out to be 4 threes are 12, then 37, 4 nines are 36, 15, so 3.75. So 393.75 rupees has to be the total profit. Right, so this was a tricky question. The division of this 40 rupees was the most important one. Okay, people usually make mistake. They take 25 and 17 to be the actual value. No, 40 has to be divided in the ratio of 25 to 17. All right, now let's take up the next question. Now this question number 17, it says Adya's present age is 3 years less than twice her age 12 years ago. All right. So if I say, first let's talk only about Adya. Adya, suppose we say present age is X years. Then 3 years less than twice her 12. So 12 years ago, 12 years ago, it must be X minus 12 years. And the question is saying that the present age is, present age of Adya is 3 years less than twice of 12 years ago. So 2 times x minus 12 minus 3. Alright. So whatever her age was 12 years ago, multiplied by 2 because twice, and then subtract 3 from there. So we have x equal to 2x minus 24 minus 3. So this gives us x subtracts from 2x. So x is equal to 27 years. Right. So the Adya's present age is 27 years. Now the question, the second part. Also the ratio of Aditi's present age to Adya's present age is 4 is to 9. So Aditi is to Adya, that is 4 is to 9. Right. Adya we have already calculated to be 27. So if 9 is 27, that is into 3. So this 4 will also get multiplied by 3 and it becomes 12. So Aditi's present age has to be 12 years. This is Aditi's present age. Right. Now, what is the question asking? Aditi's age after 5 years. So, Aditi after 5 years, you have to be careful about this. You know, Aditi's age after 5 years will be equal to the present age 12 plus 5, which is 17 years. That is second option is the correct answer. All right. Now, the 18th question. This question says, fresh fruit contains 72% water and dry fruit contains 20% water. How much dry fruit from 100 kg of fresh fruit can be obtained? Please understand that in this fresh fruit has some water and some solid content. When you create dry fruit from fresh fruit, the solid content does not change. Solid content remains constant. This is the solid content. This remains constant. This is what you have to remember and understand. Okay. The solid quantity does not change. The water quantity changes. The water evaporates from fresh fruit. Water evaporates and dry fruit. We get dry fruit. Okay. So here we have 100 kg of fresh fruit. This has 72% water. That means 28%. The solid content here will be 28% of 100 kg, right? Suppose from this we get dry fruit as x kg. Now in that x kg, 20% is water. So what will be the solid content? The solid content will be 80% of x. But you must understand that the solid content should remain constant. All right. So we say that 28% of 100, 28 by 100 into 100 is equal to 80% of x, that is 80 by 100 into x. So from here we can get the value of x. I repeat, what is important here to understand is the content or quantity of solid initially in the fresh fruit and quantity of solid in final situation, that is dry fruit, has to be the same. Water, other than water, whatever it is solid content. So if 20% water, that means 80% solid. 72% water means 28% solid, right? So here 100 and 100 get cancelled. X will be equal to, you can see it is x equal to 28 into 100 divided by 80. So simplify, 24 times 20, 5 times is 100. Okay. So this is 25 times is 100, and then 4 cancels 28 7 times. So 7 into 5 is 35. All right. So the answer is 35 kg of dry fruit can be obtained from 100 kg of fresh fruit. Right. So this was a simple question of a ratio application. Now the next one is, says two numbers are in the ratio 4:3. If the total of their individual squares is 225. Okay. I think, you know, before thinking of anything else, just take the numbers as 4x and 3x. Their squares will be 16x square plus 9x square. Their addition is 225 given. That's it. So this tells us 25x square is equal to 225. All right. So from here, we get x square equal to 225 by 25. That is 9. So this gives us x equal to 3. That's it. I mean, any other method would only take longer time than this. So the value of x is 3. Now question is, what is the by how much the first number is more than the second number? That means the difference. So difference of 4 and 3, difference of 4x and 3x, that is x. We want the difference, 4x minus 3x. That is x only, and x is 3 only. So the answer of this question is first option, that is 3. Okay, now let's take up the next question. Now the 20th question, it says, in a mixture of 50 liters, milk and water in the ratio 3:2, how much water should be added to make the ratio equal? I think before doing anything else, just divide in the ratio 3:2. So ratio is 3:2. Right, the first milk quantity will be 3 by 5 into 50, that is 30 liters. Water is 2 by 5 into 50, that is 20 liters. And from here, I think you can directly see milk is 30 liter, water is 20 liter. What do we have to do? We have to add water. So what should be the added quantity of water? So 30 minus 20, which is 10 liters. So if I add 10 liter water, they will become equal. Right, so answer is first option. So this was a direct simple question. No formula, nothing is required in this. The next one, 21. The average age of 8 men is increased by 2 years when one of them whose age is 24 years is replaced by a woman. What is the age of woman? Right, I think we, again, direct formula, direct method we should apply. Average of 8 men is increased by 2 years. So if I assume the average of original 8 men is A, right, and the person who is 24 years is going out, all right. So, and let's say, okay, so the original sum of 8 people divided by 8 should be equal to A. So from here we get original sum of 8 men, right, they should be equal to 8A. Right, now out of this 8A, the man whose age is 24 is going out, and a woman whose age is, let's say, X is coming in. Right, because it's saying replaced by. So when you say replace, one person has to go out and the new person has to come in. So the person who is going out age is 24 years, so minus 24, and the woman age is X, so add X, divide by the number of people is still 8, so it is equal to, the new average will be equal to, increased by 2 years, so original average is A, the new average will be A plus 2. So it is 8A minus 24 plus X is equal to, 8 goes to the other side and gets multiplied to 8. A plus 2, so it is 8A plus 16. So 8A and 8A get cancelled, X is equal to 24 plus 16, that is 40. So 40 years, that's it. So the age of the woman is 40 years. And as we have done in one of the earlier questions, we can do this directly also, right? The average is increases by 2 years for every person. That means the total increment will be 2 into 8, which is 16. Now increment on what? Increment on the person who is going out. So 24. So it is 16 plus 24. That is 40. Right. So this is how we could have done this question also. But in any case, normal method also does not take much longer. Okay. Now 22nd question. In the first 10 overs of a cricket game, the run rate was only 3.2. What should be the run rate in the remaining 40 overs to reach the target of 282? I think there is nothing great about this question. Right. Let's say the remaining 40 overs, the average is X. So straight away, 10 into the first 10 overs average is 3.2. So the first 10 overs total will be 10 into 3.2, right? The remaining 40 overs average is X. So total will be 40 into X. And this total should be equal to 282. I think there is nothing great about this question. Now 10 into 3.2 is 32. 32 goes to the other side. So it is 40X equal to 282 minus 32. So which is 250, right? So 40X is equal to 250. So X is equal to 250. Divide by 40. So 0 and 0 cancel. 25 by 4 is 6.25. That means the average required for the remaining 40, run rate required for the remaining 40 overs is 6.25. That is first option, which is indeed a good run rate. Okay. Now let's take up the next question. Now the next one, question number 23, this is a very interesting one. It says the sum of all positive even integers less than 1000 is A. What is the meaning of this? All positive even integers less than 1000. Now the first positive even integer is 2, then 4, then 6, up to less than 1000. The last one is 998 and not 1000. Now how many are these numbers? These are from 2 to 998, it is 2 into 1, 2 into 2, this is 2 into 499. So there are 499 even numbers, right? This is very, very important, okay? 499 even numbers, right? Now the question is saying, if the sum of all positive even integers less than 1000 is A, then what is the sum of all positive odd integers less than 1000? Now what is the meaning of this? Sum of all positive odd integers less than 1000 would mean 1, then 3, then 5, then 7, up to 999, right? Let me include 997 also. So 997 and then 999. So this is a total of 500 odd numbers. This is where a lot of people make mistake in this particular question. See, when you count less than 1000 even numbers, 1000 will not be counted and the total 499 even numbers will be there. If you count odd numbers, there will be all the odd numbers up to 999. That means total 500 odd numbers will be included. Okay. Now see, every even number here, let's say 2 is 1 more than 1. 4 is 1 more than 3. You know, the 6 will be 1 more than 5. So every even number here is 1 more than all the odd numbers here, but only up to 997. Right. Because the last number is 998. Okay, so every for the first 499 numbers, every number is one number more than that. Okay, right. So if I have to find the sum of all these numbers, what do I need to do? Okay, let me write it like this. So now the sum of these 500 odd numbers, we have to calculate it very carefully. Sum of these odd numbers, which are 500 numbers, will be equal to, let's see, let me write it like this: 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus up to 997 plus 999, right? How many numbers are these? These are 500 numbers. I'll do one thing. I'll add 500, okay? And I'll subtract 500. So what happens from this? Look at this carefully. If you add 500, now there are 500 numbers, add 1 to each one of them. So this 1 becomes 2, 3 becomes 4, 5 becomes 6, and 7 becomes 8 up to 997 becomes 998, 999 becomes 1000. So what we have done is we have distributed this 500, 1 to each of them minus this remaining 500. All right. Now you see 2 up to 998 sum is already given and that is A. Okay. So it is equal to A plus 1000 minus 500 is 500. So the answer is A plus 500, which is fourth option. So this was a very tricky question. A lot of people make a lot of mistake in this, right? What we did was I wrote all these 500 numbers. Then I added 500, subtracted 500. The 500 that I added, I gave 1 to each of the numbers. So it became 2, 4, 6, 8, up to 998 and then 1000 also. Up to 998, the sum of all the even numbers is already given as A. Remaining 1000 minus 500 is simply plus 500. So answer is A plus 500. Right? You have to be a little careful here. Now the next one, it says vessels A and B contain 4 liter and 6 liter of two different samples of acid. If the contents of two vessels are mixed, the result is 35% acid concentration. If 1 liter each from A and B are mixed, the result is 36% acid concentration. The amount of pure acid in A and B in liters. I think we'll again follow the very simple process. Okay. So let's assume that first of all, A has X percent of acid, B has Y percent of acid. The total quantity of A is 4 liters. So X percent of 4 plus total quantity of B is 6 liters. So it is Y percent of 6 liters is equal to, in the first case, it is 35%. Now, first case, when we simply add, it becomes 35% acid. That means it is 35% of total. Now, total would be 4 plus 6, that is 10. Right. So very carefully, percentage gets cancelled. So we have 4x plus, this is y percent. So 4x plus 6y equal to 35 gets cancelled. So it is 350. Right. So this is one equation that we have. Now the second one, it says if 1 liter from each is mixed, the result is 36%. Now 1 liter each mixed means x percent of 1 plus y percent of 1. You know, we are taking 1 liter from each. Then it comes out to be 36% of 1 plus 1, 2 liters. So again, percentage gets cancelled and we have x plus y is equal to 36 into 2, that is 72. Right? So basically, we have two variables, two equations. Simplify this. So what I'll do is I'll write the second equation here again, our first equation here again, 4x plus 6y equal to 350, and multiply the first equation by 4. Right, so into 4. So it is 4x plus 4y equal to 72 into 4, that is 288. Right, now simply subtract. So minus, minus, minus. So 4x minus 4x, 6y minus 4y is 2y equal to 350 minus 288 is 5062. So y is equal to 31%. The y value is 31 and it is in percentage. If you put y is 31 in the first one, in this equation, you will get x equal to 42 minus 31, that is 72 minus 31 is 41%, right? So we have got the percentage concentrations in the two mixtures, right? So A has 41% and B has 31%, and the original quantities of A and B were 4 liters and 6 liters. All right. So out of 4 liter, 41%. So 4 fours are 16.4 or 1.64 liters. Okay, and in the second one, out of 6 liter, 31 plus 6 threes are 1860, so 1.86 liters, right? So the quantities of acid earlier, originally was 1.64 liter and 1.86 liter, that is third option is the correct answer. All right, now let's take up the next question. Now this question, it says in a partnership, A invests 6th portion of the capital for 6th portion of time. Okay, B invests 3rd portion of the capital for 3rd portion of the time, and C the rest of the capital for the whole time. Alright, and find A share of the total profit of rupees 2300. So if I assume total time to be, let's say, 12 months. Okay. Then, and let's say the total investment to be 1 rupee, right? Let's keep it simple. Then what will happen? A, B and C, their investments will be, A invest 1/6 of the investment, okay? B invest 3rd portion, so 1/3. Now, whatever remains will be invested by C. So, out of 1, 1 by 6 is gone, 1 by 3 is gone. So, simplify. This will be LCM 6, 6 minus 3, 6 minus 1 minus 2. So, 2 and 1, 3, so it is 3 by 6. 3 by 6 means it is 1 by 2. So, simply 1 by 2. Then comes the time duration. In the time duration, C was there for the whole time. So, 12 months, right? I am writing M for months. And A invests for 6th portion of time. So 12 months divided by 6. So 2 months. And B invests 3rd portion of the time. So 1/3. 1/3, that is 12 divided by 3. 4 months. Now the profit share will be the multiplication of this. So profit share will be multiplication of investment into time. So for A it will be 1 by 6 into 2. For B it will be 1 by 3 into 4. And for C it will be 1 by 2 into 12. Right, so if you simplify, 1 by 6 into 2, 2 by 6 is 1 by 3, then 4 by 3, and then 12 by 2 is 6. So multiply by 3, you will get 1 is to 4 is to, it is 6 threes are 18. Right, so the ratio of profit share of ABC has to be this one. Now, what is the question asking? Find A's share of the total profit is 2300. So total profit is 2300 rupees. So divide 2300 in this ratio. And you can find the share of each one. But we have to find only the share of A. So A's share will be 1 divided by 23. 1 plus 4 is 5 plus 18, 23 into 2300. So 23 cancels 2300 100 times. So the final answer is rupees 100. So share of A is 100 rupees, which is first option. That is the correct answer. Okay. Now the next one, it says the denominator of a fraction is greater than its numerator by 5. But if 7 were added to denominator, the value of the fraction would become 1 by 4. I think it's very simple. Okay. If I take the denominator is greater than numerator. So let's say the new fraction is numerator x and denominator x plus 5. Right. The denominator is greater than numerator by 5. Correct. This is the original fraction. Okay. Now the question is 7 were added. So x plus 7. But at the denominator, it is 7 were added to the denominator. So the numerator remains same x, and denominator, which was x plus 5, add 7 to it. the new ratio will become 1 by 4, right? So simplify, cross multiply, if you do that, you will get 4x equal to x plus 12. So this gives us 3x equal to 12. Great, so x is equal to 4. Put it here in the first one, it is 4 divided by 4 plus 5, that is 9. So the answer is 4 by 9, so simple question, okay. Now the next one, so the average temperature for the first 4 days of a week is 40.2 and then of the last 4 days is 41. If the average temperature for the whole week is 40.6, temperature on the 4th days. Understand this very carefully, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So the first 4 days, so let me say sum of these 4 days will be equal to, the average of these 4 days is 40.2. So it is 40.2 into 4. Similarly, the average of these 4 days, the last 4 days is 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th. That is 41 degree, alright. So the sum of these 4 days, the last ones, and these were the first ones, this will be equal to 41 into 4. So 40.2 into 4 will be 160.8 and 41 into 4 will be 164, right? But both of these values include the 4th day. So if I have to calculate, let's say the total sum of all 7 days, how do we do that? Total sum of all 7 days must be equal to the sum of first 4 days, that is 160.8, plus the sum of last 4 days, that is 164, and the 4th day has to be subtracted because the 4th day is coming twice, but we cannot take twice, we have to take it only once. So we subtract it once. So suppose 4th day is x, okay, so minus x. Now what will be the sum of all 4 days? That can be calculated from here. The average of all 7 days, whole week is 40.6. So sum of 7 days will be 40.6 into 7 equal to 160.8 plus 164, that is 324.8 minus x. And 40.6 into 7, if you multiply, it will give us 7 6 is 42. Alright, 4 7 is 280. So 280 and 284.2, that is equal to 324.8 minus x. So from here you can see that x is equal to 324.8 minus 284.2, so it is equal to 40.6. Oh, right. So it is 40.6 only. 40.6 degrees centigrade, which is the first option. All right. Whatever the answer comes, then don't worry too much about it. Now the next one, 28th one, it says ABC invested rupees 8,000, 4,000 and 8,000 respectively in a business. A left after 6 months and B 1 month later to A. If after 8 months, there was a gain of rupees 4,011, what will be the share of B? Correct. So first we take investment and then we take time. A's investment is 8,000, B's investment is 4,000 and C's investment is 8,000, right? A left after 6 months. Out of 8 months, A left after 6 months. So he was there for 6 months. And B 1 month later to A. So B was there for 7 months. C was there for the entire duration because nothing is mentioned. So it is 8 months. So their profit share would be a direct multiplication of this. It will be 8,000 into 6 is 2. B will be 4,000 into 7 is to 8,000 into 8. Alright. So 3 zeros are directly cancelled. Okay. So it is 8 6 are 48 is to 4 7 are 28 is to 64. If you simplify further by division of 4, it will be 12 is to 7 is to 16. This is the ratio of profit. And what is this is the ratio of profit of ABC. And what is the total profit? The total profit is 4011 and we want the profit share of B. So B share will be equal to 7 divided by 12 plus 7 is 19, 19 plus 6 is 16. 12 plus 7 is 19, 19 plus 16 is 35. All right. So it is 35 multiplied by 4011. Okay. So B share will be 7 upon 35 into 4011. So this will be equal to 7 cancels 35 5 times. So 4011 by 5 is approximately equal to 5802.2 rupees. So the share of B is 802.2 rupees. Now if you look at the option, there is no option which is correct here. So don't worry, there must be some mistake in the typing. No option is correct. The correct answer is 802.2. So always, what you have to understand, if this is the question, answer should be 802.2. All right. Now let's take up the next question. This is a direct question. 29th one, it says that fourth proportion of 236. So 236 and x, the rule is 2 by 3 should be equal to 6 by x. As simple as that. So 2 cancels 6 3 times, x is equal to 3 into 3, that is 9. That's it. So third option is the correct answer. 30th question, it says the salaries of Devi Bhai and Dayal Bhai are in the ratio 2:3. They got appraisal and now salary of each increased by 4000. The new ratio becomes 4:7. So let's take the original incomes as 2x and 3x. So 2x plus 4000, the new income, and 3x plus 4000, the new income. This ratio is equal to 4:7. So simplify it first. So if you cross multiply, 7 2's is 14x plus 28,000 is equal to 4 3's is 12x plus 16,000. So this gives us 2x is equal to 14x, 28,000 equal to 12x plus 16,000. Oh, so this gives us 2x is equal to 28,000 goes to the other side. 16,000 minus 28,000 is minus 12,000. So x is negative. How can a salary be negative? That means this data is wrong. So we say that it is inadequate data, right? Inadequate data. So here the answer should have been data is insufficient or data is inadequate, but it's not there. None of these is there. So we'll mark none of these as our answer. Please understand that this data is inadequate because we are getting negative salaries, which is not possible. All right. So this is wrong. Everything is wrong in this question. Okay. Now the next one, 31st question. It says 2 gallons of mixture of spirit and water contain 12% of water. It has been added with 3 gallons of another mixture containing 7% of water. So quantities are 2 gallons and 3 gallons. Percentages of water 12% and 7%. And half a gallon water is then added to whole. The percentage of water in the resulting mixture. Let's calculate total water quantity. Total water quantity will be 12% of 2 gallons plus 7% of 3 gallons plus half a gallon, that means let's say 0.5 gallons. So the total quantity, 12% of 2 will be 24, 0.24 plus 7% of 3, that is 0.21 plus 0.5 gallons, right? If you add all of them, you'll get 24 plus 21, that is 45 and 50, 95, so 0.95 gallon. What is the question? The percentage of water. So water percentage now will be equal to, very carefully, it is this was 0.95, I'm sorry, this was 0.95. If you add all of them, you will get 0.95. Okay. So the water percentage will be total water, that is 0.95, divided by the total quantity of water. This is 2 gallons plus 3 gallons. 2 plus 3 is 5. 5 plus half a gallon, that is 0.5. Right. So it is 5.5 gallon. Into 100. This will be the percentage of water. So what we get here is, you know, if you simplify a little bit, you will get 95 upon 5.5, that is 950 upon 55. Divide by 5, it is 190 divided by 11%. So after simplification, we can see that it comes out to be, you know, 111.87. So it is 17 times, 3 by 11 is 0.27. Okay, so 17.27. So a little bit of calculation, obviously, in the end. Fourth option, that is 17.27%, is the correct answer. All right, so this is where we have completed exercise MT26. Thank you so much. God bless you. Take care.